Thank you, Andy. Good afternoon, everybody. I'd like to say to the students of UConn, before we had FaceTime, before we had Zoom, we used to write a lot of letters. And Chris Dodd wrote a book called Letters from Nuremberg. It was about letters that his dad wrote when he was at Nuremberg at the age of 38, across the Atlantic from his family. And it were letters from the heart, letters where he asked how his wife Grace was doing, how the kids were doing, what they were making for dinner. And Grace, I'm thinking about you whenever I hear when Irish eyes are smiling. That's what I'm listening to right now. His letters also talked about what the meaning of Nuremberg was. This was at the end of World War II. And the question was, how do you deal with these Nazi leaders? Some thought, maybe you should have a trial. Stalin said, what's a trial? Even Winston Churchill said, maybe they should just be executed. But the President of the United States and Judge Jackson and Thomas Dodd thought otherwise. They said, America is super because of the power of our ideals. That's what makes us super. And we're going to stay true to our ideals, true to a rule of law, true to the fact that these people are going to be tried in a courtroom setting, and the evidence is going to be laid out in front of the people around the world, and they will get their just desserts. And that's just what happened. And young attorney, 38-year-old Thomas Dodd, led the way in that prosecution. And that was, to some degree, the world's introduction to America as a superpower and what we stood for. More than our military might, it was the power of our ideals, the power of the rule of law, the power of human rights. That's what that represented, and that's what that statement was, and that's what that book was about, and that's what Thomas Dodd was about. And then he came home, and he got home, and he saw his young son, Chris, for the first time, just learning to walk, barely able to walk. And as they say, they started calling Chris Dodd the shadow, because he followed his dad everywhere he went. And fast forward 30 years, Chris followed his dad into Congress, and followed his dad into the US Senate, and followed his dad in terms of representing the very best ideals of this country, especially when it came to kids and family, and family and medical leave, and childcare, and everything that he thought was important to the American ideal going forward. And that's why this center is named after Thomas and Chris Dodd. Chris was telling me, though, that just a few months ago, he was got a letter. And he got a letter from a professor from Alabama State. And the professor said, back in 1960, we had a protest, African-American kids protesting on college, protesting segregation. And the silence was deafening. But then they started getting some messages from the University of Connecticut, messages from students at the University of Connecticut, some cash included with those messages from the students at the University of Connecticut. And the professor asked, and who was Jeremy Dodd? Because Jeremy Dodd is the person that made this happen. I don't know, there's something in the water in that Dodd family, and I hope you guys are all drinking it. And I'd like to think that the Dodd Center is all about those family dinners, back and forth, talking about what makes America special, what makes America great, being true to our values, true to ourselves, true to human rights. And if UConn and the Dodd Center can help establish that and make sure the next generation follows on what Tom and Chris Dodd did, we'll be a better country for it. Thanks, everybody.